Now let's consider the if-then statements. Now the diagram here shows a relationship that can be expressed in three ways. If you look at the diagram here, we have here poets, and that is a subset of writers. So here we can say that all poets are writers, because if you're inside this set here, you are also inside the bigger set, the set of writers. So you say all poets are writers. Equivalently, you could also say that there are no poets that are not writers. Or you could also say if a person is a poet, then a person is also a writer. That third statement is the if then statement. So if, and then you write the statement, then you write the second statement. So if a person is a poet, then that person is a writer. The if then statement can be represented using Venn diagram as this. So the compound statement if P then Q is written symbolically as this. We use the arrow symbol for the if P then statement. Now this statement is also called a conditional statement. The statement that comes before the arrow symbol is called the antecedent, and the statement that comes after this symbol here is called the consequent. The antecedent is the statement that comes first, then the symbol, the arrow symbol, followed then by the statement, the next statement, which is called the consequent. Now, to illustrate this, let's consider the following simple statements. Let P represent the statement, a person is a father, and Q represent the statement, a person is a male. Write each compound statement below in symbolic form. So first we have a person is a father, then that person is a male. A person is a father is represented by P. And then that person is a male is represented by Q. We have the if and then statement here. We have if and then. So since we have this statement here, we would use this symbol. Think of this as then. So if P, then Q. So the symbolic form for if a person is a father, then that person is a male is P, then Q. Let's consider this next statement. A person is not a male. Then that person is not a father. A person is not a male is the negation of this statement. So this first statement here is not Q. After the word then is that person is not a father. Person is not a father is a negation of P. So therefore, symbolically, since this is an if-then statement, which can be represented by an arrow, we have not Q, then not P. Not Q, because this is again a negation of this statement. And that person is not the father is a negation of P. So negation of P. So in symbolic form, the statement, if a person is not the male, then that person is not a father, is written in this way. Now, in this section or in this topic, you would be asked to write the symbolic form of some statements or English expressions. So it is important to take note the different forms for P then Q. So all of these English statements here can be written as P then Q. Most common is if P then Q. It can be symbolically be written as P then Q. Or you could also have Q if P. Just take note that the statement that comes after the word if would be your antecedent. So if it is written as Q if P, you know that you would write that as P then Q. For sufficient, if we have P is sufficient for Q, you would write this as P or Q. But if you have Q is necessary for P, this is written as P then Q. Also, we have P only if. So this is kind of different than this one. This only has the word if. But if you have only if, that means different. So if you have P only if Q, that would mean P then Q. So if you have the word only before if, this is written as symbolically as P and then arrow Q. It's the same thing. You have to write P first and then arrow Q. Now let's look at some example. Suppose you have this statement, a person is a father, is represented by P. And then next, a person is a male, is represented by Q. If you write it in an if-then statement form, you would say this as, if a person is a father, then that person is a male. If you write it this way, a person is a male, if that person is a father. Or you could also say, being a father is sufficient for being a male. Or you could say, being a male is necessary for being a father. Those statements all mean the same thing. They all can be written symbolically as P then Q or P R O Q. So another way also you could say a person is a father only if that person is a male. Only if a person is a male is that person a father. The one thing that is very important here is to take note of all these format here. So these are the different forms for P then Q. I want you to familiarize yourself with this one.